I think I need to change my friends, but okay. Hello, good afternoon, everybody. My name is Rafael Neder. I am a professor and designer in Belo Horizonte, a city 600 kilometers from here. And as you can see, my English is really bad. So I apologize, and I hope you all understand me. Brazilian people, I think you guys get the transcripted version will be more clear. Okay, so let's go. In Brazil, we have a proverb that says, in hell, hug the devil. So, in moments of trouble, carry on. It's what I'm feeling right now. Okay, that was in 2006 when my passion for letterpress design began. At that time, I took some classes in Belo Horizonte and in São Paulo. And in São Paulo, especially in a place called Oficina Tipográfica. At that moment, I was trying to understand the relations between letterpress technology and the design process in the digital age. Questions about the design of typefaces, grid systems, and everything else. A lot of things start to flow from my mind after this experience. At that time, I divided my hours working with user experience design, codes, debugging codes, to be more honest, and classes, but the passion for type, the smell of paints, and the materiality of the machines took me to the direction of letterpress workshops. In the 2007 vacation, I'm offered to work as an apprentice to one of the last typographers in the city. The man is Ademir Matias. We'll see him in my presentation. From that experience, grow a friendship and many projects. One of them is a workshop of letterpress that we took in Belo Horizonte for almost 8 years. Since then, we teach letterpress to young professionals, students, and people interested in that subject. After some time, I meet another designers and artists who, like us in Belo Horizonte, are dedicated to research about letterpress. From these meetings, the interest to investigate the motivations and characteristics of this Brazilian revival grow in my research board. In the context of my master research, I think it's not. Oh, claro. Posso começar em português, mineirês e língua do P. Qual que vocês preferem? In the context of my master research, through 2 years and a half, I could visit different cities where I found and interviewed many designers, artists, and printers. Some friends from old times, from Diatipo, another meetings of typography, people that I know through mail, and I try to understand their motivations and record their histories. In a first moment, from the 13 groups initially identified, 8 are selected. So in a second moment, I needed to do the interviews, and I traveled all over these places, something like, I don't know, more than 600,000 kilometers going to São Paulo. I live in Belo Horizonte, but I work in São Paulo, and I took my classes in my master here in São Paulo. And after this, I go to Recife, far away in Northeast, go to Caruaru, and even Florianópolis in the south. You guys will see in the map. In the second moment, I took those interviews. And to conduct and analyze the collected data, some methodologies of oral history are used. et al. 7 hours of testimonials are recorded and transcribed into a 115-page report, plus the thesis, more 150,000. Okay. Most part of the interviews are video recorded and in the working spaces of the interviewees. Now, for each interview, I show a video about this place and those talented professionals. The 13 initiatives from all these places here in the map, I found just few that fit in my interest of investigation. Okay. So, the first one, Laboratório de Tipografia do Agreste, led by at the time by Leonardo Bugge, and Experimentando Tipos from Isabelle Aragão e Rosângela Vieira. This is Bugge, a smiling man, as all can see. I don't think so, sorry. No, maybe a little, but I need to drink before. Okay. Caruaru is a city far away, 100 kilometers from Recife. It is the start of the Brazilian outback, a place really beautiful but seco. Enfim, dry, yeah. Bugge started his letterpress workshop when he becomes professor in University Federal of Pernambuco. Okay, let me show the video. The next one, Isabella, from Recife, in the northeast coast of Brazil, a beautiful city. São Paulo is the ugliest city in South America. Sorry to say. I need to say that.
But you love it.
Yeah, I love it. But the smell, I can describe in a polite way. So, let me show the Isabella work. Someone before the end of Isabella's presentation told, oh, grotesca, reforma, gorda, apertada. Gorda is fat. In Portuguese, we don't have, at that time, nice names to explain how the type looks. So let's try it. Oh, grotesca, gorda, apertada. It's a nice name. Okay, let's go. From Pernambuco, we go to Minas Gerais, my homeland. In Minas Gerais, we have a lot of workshops of typography working now. We have a museum dedicated to the theme in Diamantina, a small city in the north of our state. We have in Belo Horizonte another museum called Museu Vivo Memoria Gráfica. And we have Tipografia do Zé, from my friend and colleague in the university, Flavio Vignoli. Tipografia do Zé is a small publisher focused in handmade books. You guys know Santa Claus or Gutenberg grandson? During the research, I have a focus to understand how contemporary graphic designers are trying to understand how to use and operate all the printing machines. And one day I tried to take a class of intertype composition, and that day I think, oh, let's go another thing. It's much more easy to. We'll be right back. back to São Paulo. In São Paulo, we have a lot of people working with typography too, with letterpress too. Oficina Tipográfica is the pioneer in that subject in Brazil. At that time, with Claudio Rocha, Marcos Melo, and Claudio Ferlaudo here too, they started to collect from the last typographers in the city a huge and beautiful collection of type and wood type. It's a lovely place, something like Disneylandia to me. Okay, Mr. Claudio Rocha, Mr. Marcos Melo. That work of Claudio are thousands of ink layers here. He do with a passion that's difficult to see in nowadays in contemporary design field. I really like this work. And this is over offset plate, Claudio. I think it's from São Paulo too, but born and raised in Belo Horizonte, Eloísa Teuvina. That's very funny. We have a lot of friends in common, but I only know Eloisa here in São Paulo at TPC 10. We are in a course, in a class, sorry, in Oficina Tipográfica. Oficina Tipográfica works like a hub to Brazilian type designers, typographers, graphic designers. They offered this classes. It's a really good opportunity. Letterpress with a beautiful workshop full of machines from the past decades is really easy. Imagine you do that in a small apartment, just like Eloisa do. Well, first, the weight, the problems of or the operation of the machines. She's a kind of hero to me too. I really need new friends.